regenerating health in the dark world? Collectible ammo for my gun? You're selling me out, Retro! Hashtag kidding, hashtag love yas. Hello everybody, how's it going? This is Will here, and we are back with another episode of Metroid Prime. Samus did not seem too happy about what she just figured out. Oh my lord, I'm going the wrong way. Double oh my lord. Two lords going on right now, guys. That is blasphemous at best. Well, you want to know what happened in the last episode? We fought and killed Dark Samus, apparently. Since you were dying to know, I figured. Also, I talked a lot about the newest season of Pokemon, I guess, when in the midst of saying what I was doing, because literally when I have free time lately, it's pretty much all I do. And funny thing, I think I've explained this before, like how I see like the days of the week, like in terms of like from best to worst. I'm pretty sure I've explained this. But basically the way I see it is, I always thought Thursday was the worst day of the week. Because on Sunday, it sucks that the next day is going to be Monday, but you can at least hold true to the fact that you still have a day off on that day. And on Monday, you're kind of glad that, Mondays do suck, but it means, like, you can look forward to Tuesday, because then it won't be Monday anymore. And on Tuesday, you're glad because then it's not Monday anymore. On Wednesday, you feel kind of good about things because it's the middle of the week, like you made it halfway through, you know? On Thursday, you could always say it's good to look forward to Friday, but not really, because then you're looking forward to the end of the week, which is over to your weekend, which is just going to spawn another week. So, like, you can end up, like, overthinking it. And then Saturdays are just generally awesome because they're Saturdays. But, like, Thursdays, I don't know. I always thought Thursdays were the worst day of the week. But, again, tying it into the whole Pokemon thing, Thursdays are now one of my favorite days of the week because I know that that's when a new episode airs in Japan. So, I'm always super excited on my, There's a thing here. There's a thing somewhere. Pretty sure. I guess not. What the hell, man? So there's just nothing in here. But yeah, anyway, that's why. Oh! Ew! Look at that! My eye spy skills have improved. Okay, so after friggin' half an hour of just wandering around doing absolutely nothing, wondering what I'm doing with my life, I finally figured out, look at this, it's popping up now. I finally remembered where it is I have to go. There is actually a portal I have to go into. I completely forgot about it. It was the one in the pirate base. Yeah, way over there. It was in the main room. And I even commented on it and everything, I think, when I walked in. But I guess I took no heed of it, as I recorded two halves of the area on separate days, so that was my bad, I guess. I should have paced my recordings a bit better, I guess, on my part. But all that matters is, through the magic of editing, this is going to feel like no time at all. Let's go in here and open up the portal. You know? Into the portal, jump in. Oh, good lord. It's been a while since I've referenced that, jeez. When was the last time I referenced that? Was that Turok? Yeah, look at this. See this dinky little thing over here that I completely passed by, unbeknownst? You have to shoot it with the dark beam, yeah. Because I remember when you get the other beam, it works the opposite way. You can kind of do like pretty much all the opposite things. Yeah, so. There's the second Dark Aegon key up there, though, so that's good. But the problem is that it is friggin' crazy how long we're going to be in Dark Aegon now, because I'm pretty sure this is the section where you have to fight the really hard boss, but the really awesome boss, too. Like, the boss that I fought, it made me realize, like, man, Metroid is a friggin' awesome series. So they're saying there's just a... Oh, there is, too! Look at that! Huh. I don't think we can... Yeah, we can't go in that one yet, though. because we don't have the other beam to activate it. And what the hell is this big black thing? Contains a number of motivator units. It appears to be a component in some sort of transportation system. Okay. I'll take note of that then, so that probably means we have to do something with it. I bet it's integral to some kind of puzzle we got going here. I'm betting. Yeah, look at that, I saw it. I saw it up there. You gotta shoot it. And then you gotta jump on top. And then you gotta wait for the timer. Or do we just, I guess we just jump across from here. Okay. I'm fine with that. Blow up the missile door. Love it, man. Love it when things go fluently. I love it. I love me some progress. I really do, man. Nothing feels more satisfying in this game than just progressing. Like having your exploration have payoff. Which is why like progress and like collection is like best thing, you know? Like it's those endorphins, man. Those endolphins. The Nintendo endorphin. Wouldn't it be weird if Nintendo named a console the Endorphin? Wouldn't that just be... That would just be like a weird kind of thing for Nintendo to do, to name it after like a hormone. That would be very strange, I would have to say. Definitely be one of... What is that thing? Oh, that's the safe zone thing. Okay. Okay, we can't go in there yet. That's all phase on. I'm not even gonna bother with that crap. We already know from the first Metroid Prime what that did to me. Trying to go through there. Alright, let's see what happens with this. This just takes me down, I guess. Whoa. Dude, this place looks freaking cool. I've gotta say. It looks pretty great. Just the atmosphere, man. Dad atmosphere. Scan that. There we go. Are there any others we can... Yeah, there's one right there. Nice. Very nice. Oh, God. I hate that sound when you hit the phase on. It's such a creepy sound, man. We've got a red. What's the red do? One of three locks are offline. Oh, okay. Well, I just accidentally figured out what the puzzle in this room is. We have to... Okay, I've already scanned that one. All right. So there's a bunch of locks around here that I gotta scan. There's one. Very nice. There's two of the three locks, and now there's a third one. And I have a sneaking suspicion that the third one is up on a height somewhere. Yeah, like up around there somewhere, I'm betting. Just 'cause, you know, it really would just be like the logical place to put a third one. But let's see. Imagine if it was like right up there, like just right by the door. Well, close enough, I guess. And there we go. Cool. That wasn't so bad. Well, that one wasn't so bad. I'm sure it's only going to get worse. Oh god, oh god, oh god, oh. Oh, the phase on. Not good. It stacks with the friggin' Dark World damage. Not good. That'll kill you nice and quickly. Let me tell ya. Okay, so I can't do anything to that, right? No, okay. Oh no, I could. Okay, alright. Whoa, 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 whoa. The hell is that thing? It's an Ingclaw, a toxin-spewing immobile darkling. Gross, man. Yeah, I realized that it creates a deadly vapor. That was nuts. I didn't realize they were that dangerous. Oh, I should probably scan these things too, eh? Oh no, I've already scanned them. Okay. Oh, these are just like the little energy bugs, aren't they? Yeah, I think. Ooh, give me that. Okay. Let's stop dawdling. Let's go through here. Yeah. Nice. Okay. So we've got a white door and black door. Okay. Let's stock up on it. This is your prime. This is honestly your prime concern in this area. Keep an eye on your health like never before in a game before. Like, honestly, you do not want to be caught with low health at any point in this section. Alright, there's another door we can't open. Even though we do have a form of light energy, I still don't understand that, but... again, whatever. Sure, whatever. We'll roll with it, we'll roll with it. It's fine, it's fine. Okay, oh, good lord, oh, good lord. Okay, alright, well, let's take care of those whatever the things are. Let's just get rid of all of them. There. Let's just clear the way. There. There. There's only like two left. That's easy to dodge. Yeah. Alright, let's take care of these ones now. Because we have to. Otherwise, it will not end well. Alright. Oh, but now I have to find the friggin' jewel thing on this one. Ugh. And where is it? Let me guess. It's on, like, the most inconvenient angle this thing could possibly be sitting on. Or not at all. Okay. Where is it, then? What the... Where is it? Maybe it was just up here, or... What is going on? Maybe I'm just looking at this the wrong way. Maybe I have to, like... Ugh. Oh yeah, look at that. It is just right there. I'm just an idiot. Can't. See, there's this ongoing joke in my family. No, I should. Never mind. I won't tell that joke. That's a joke I shouldn't tell. Not a joke, but like a story I shouldn't tell. Whatever. Forget I said anything. Maybe I'll tell it one day, but we don't have enough trust yet, viewer. Is your Elder Scrolls persuasive skill high enough? Can you persuade me to share the story with you? I bet you can't. I'd be pretty tough to crack, I bet. Who can ever read me like an open book? No one. Oh jeez, oh jeez, oh jeez. I'm just sitting here, oh jeez, oh jeez. Maybe I'm a bit tougher of a book to read than you thought. Profound mental processes. What is this? Ooh, it looks like a little halo. Oh, look at that! Again, makes no sense. But, egad. Wow. Light beam. How do you fire such light? Well, you switch with C-stick, and boom. Light beam. So impressive. Bright lights. Wow. Alright, well. So as we can see by like you can even tell just by like the animation on the beam and everything. Like, it's the plasma beam. It's the friggin' plasma beam. Not that I'm complaining, because the plasma beam was the best. It really was. That was a great little beam. Look at that. And a great new little mechanic that they've added is, you can kill enemies with the, light beam to collect, ooh, dark beam ammo, and you can kill enemies with the dark beam to collect light beam ammo, so, basically it's like trying to keep a balance of your ammo by killing enemies with certain weapons, which is really freaking cool, I think. I think that's pretty awesome. We have to go over to the light beam door, because now that we have the light beam... Oh my god, so many friggin' pathways have opened up to us now. It's redonkulous, pretty much. It's pretty much the greatest thing ever, really. Let's take a scan of this. I'm assuming we can probably just kill this with the light beam. Yeah, I'm guessing, yeah. Figured about as much, as we can see. And, there we go. So let's just see if we can find like the next little checkpoint sort of thing going here. And then we'll skedaddle on out of here. Oh yeah, we have to collect that Dark Aegon key too. I didn't collect that. Oh yeah. So there's only one more to get, too. Nice. Fine with that. Let's open this. I have a funny feeling that this might, like, lead to a save point or something, maybe. Ugh. Get out of here. Get out of here!
Get out of here!
Son of a gun. Come on. Just... Jeez, man. They have a lot of health. Ooh, but he gave me a lot of health, so... Again, I guess I shouldn't complain too much. Alright. Ooh. Ooh, I want down there. How do I get down? I probably can't get down yet, can I? This game just... It teases you with wanting things. And then it just doesn't give them to you. It's so torturous. I can't go in there either. What is the point? What is... Oh. Well, I guess that's the point. That would make sense, actually. That we can just jump down here and grab the key. Oh. Okay. Yeah, just take the key from me. Alright. Sure. No problem. I don't care. Ooh, maybe this is another power-up or something, though. Oh, wouldn't that be great? Maybe this is another boss? Oh no, it's just a bunch of hunters. A bunch of hunter-ing. This is the time, man. In the next episode, that is when we're going to, that's when we're going to fight the really freaking cool boss. Oh, look, and I'm down here again. All these freaking, I remember those things from the last game. Those darn little whippets things, whatever they're called. Darkling Tentacle. Okay, well, that's a pretty generic name. I remember them having a different name than that. But I don't think they're called Whippets or anything, but that sounds like a freaking, like, Banjo-Kazooie name for an enemy. Whippets. Well, I think they're called Whiplash, I guess, in Banjo-Kazooie. In the Banjo-Kazooie games. So where do I go from here? Whatever, I'll just end the episode. I think I actually remember there's, like, there's a freaking thing over there, isn't there? Wait. Before we end the episode, there's a light door I can go in over here. This is the charm of the freaking games, right? Like, you just gotta explore. Like, if there's a thing, you gotta go check out the thing. Why did I use the light beam on the dark door? I don't know. It's what I've been taught since Zelda. You use the light weapon on the dark thing. And never vice versa, because in Zelda, you never have the dark thing. I guess, but still... You know, same principle. Light and dark are opposites. You gotta... Look, I just did it again. Oh, my lord. Okay, there we go. And what's that? Oh, an ammo station. Okay. I'm fine with that. I usually find myself running out of ammo in this game, so... I'm totally fine with the ammo station. I'm not being misled. It does not look like a save point in any way. So that's good. They're not friggin' messing with me. Oh, and how nice of them to have their ammo station require ammo to open. It's impossible. It is physically impossible without hacking to leave that room without using ammo. That's awful. That's horrid. That's probably the most horrible thing you could ever do to somebody playing this game. I'll stop friggin' just going on about crap. Shut up, Will. Peace.